And welcome to my channel. For those of you who are new, some of you guys are probably like, I've seen you in this setup, I've seen you in this outfit before. I'm filming two videos at once. Please don't judge. This video is long overdue. I have tried to figure out ways to relay the information as detailed and as clear as possible for you guys, and it's kind of hard because there's a lot of stuff that goes into it. It's simple, but there's a lot of like little steps that you have to do. It's hard to break it up and know what to put where and this, that, and the third. Anyways, all that to be said, you guys read the title. That's the reason why you clicked on it. This is a video on how I film. I am a new YouTuber, as you guys can see, and I don't have like all this crazy equipment. I just have my camera, a ring light, and my laptop, and that's it. I'm just gonna show you guys how I get setups like these and make them look decent. I'm gonna give you guys a rundown of the camera I use, the lighting that I use, adapters, the laptop, all of that jazz, and what I do to create setups like these. Make sure to stick around because I think it's pretty explanatory. Let's get into it. So the first thing that I do when I'm getting ready to film is make sure that ahead of time I know what video I'm doing. I'll try and sit down and plan it out a little bit rather than, you know, not knowing anything that I'm gonna do. Make sure that you're just prepared and try and prepare yourself in the best way possible. Also, with that being said, certain videos require certain setup. It'll kind of throw the whole video off if the setup isn't right. So that's something to keep in mind as well. You pay attention to the details because it does kind of show. As far as placement goes, I usually find a place where I want to sit. So right now I'm sitting in this chair, and what I did before I sat down was focus the camera as much as possible on this chair so that the background is just a little blurred, and that's how I got the picture that I wanted. But I usually autofocus that. There's a little knob on the front of the lens that focuses. Even I still struggle with this. I am pretty new with all of this. Just make sure that you have as much planned out as you possibly can so that everything goes as smooth as possible. It's a lot easier on you. All right, so now we're gonna start getting into the techie. I'm just gonna show you guys the details for this setup that I have currently. There's a few tweaks and things that you have to do for different setups, but for the most part it's the same thing. So I'm gonna give you guys the basic settings that I do for my camera whenever I film, the lighting that I use, and things like that. To start off, my camera is the EOS 800D, or I believe it is also called the Rebel T7i. They are the same camera, and I have a video really descriptive on what exactly my camera is, the make and the model, how much I paid for that in a different video. It was my first video, I think, of 2021. So if you want to go back, I'll also put it on the screen so that you guys can go and check that out so that you get a little more detailed description of what the camera is. But in this video, I'm just going to focus more on what the camera does. That's the camera that I use, and I do just use the kit lens that came with it. Your girl don't have that much money, okay? I have money to go out and pay for a separate lens, which I am in the process of saving for. Just know that a YouTube channel is an investment. Also, you don't have to have all this crazy expensive stuff, especially if you don't know if it's gonna be something that you're gonna do for long term. It's just a matter of making sure you know what you're doing when you're putting money into it, and don't waste your money because it's not worth it. Anyways, I didn't have the money to get any other special lens, but there are a whole bunch of lenses. There's plenty of videos to do research on that if you're thinking about getting the camera but you want a different lens. All right, so for my camera, I actually do not have a separate tripod at all. I actually just use my ring light. I think I've showed this in my videos a few times before. My boyfriend actually got it for me one day when I was down, but I just wasn't feeling myself and hadn't been feeling myself for a while, and he treated me with a ring light. This ring light I think was a little over $100. I'll put all that details and stuff in the description for you guys and probably somewhere on the screen to help you out. So I just have this ring light and I love it because it's so convenient to have my light and my tripod all together. It's more convenient for me because I am always traveling from school to home, so it's just convenient when I want to come home. But hopefully I'll have some like in both places eventually. I mean, Christmas and my birthday is coming up, so I mean, if any of my family is watching, y'all can always get me this, that, and the third. But no, I'm just playing. But not really. Though it just makes it a little more convenient. But I love this tripod. It's very adjustable. You can change it on different levels. You can also change the height of it through the legs. You can bend the ring light and flip it upwards. You can bend it downwards if you want like a downward angle. And it's a tripod too, so it holds your camera directly into the center. My suggestion for your first ever lighting that you invest in is a ring light. I think it's just the most affordable. You get pretty good lighting rather than only having one light. Run the risk of you can have shadows or it just doesn't illuminate the room as much. The ring light literally has lights all around it, so you have light coming downwards, upwards, around you. And you know, I just think it's the better investment in my opinion, and I'm so happy that this is what I was gifted. But and this one is a pretty good option, like I said, because not only is it more convenient, but you're saving money technically because your light and your tripod are all in one. Okay, so for this ring light, a few things that come with it, like I said, it does have the tripod and it's very adjustable, but you also have temperature settings on it and brightness. The same little knob that turns the light on is what controls the brightness, as well as the other knob that just adjusts it from a white light to a warm light. That's convenient too. It's two lightings in one. You can't always use the same lighting in different settings. It just depends, and it's personal preference. For me, I kind of just leave it always on white light. I just like the way that it looks better, but some people prefer a warm light, so that's convenient that it all comes in one and you'll have it whenever you need either one. So on my camera, the only accessories that I have are the microphone. I will also put on the screen and in the description what exactly they are, but I do have a microphone, an external microphone plugged into my camera, and it sits on top of it. And I like this because it diffuses sound, especially when I'm vlogging. I use the same camera to vlog with because it diffuses that sound and pays attention to your voice, which is pretty cool. It just helps a lot with that. Also, the microphone, in my opinion, works better than using the microphone built into the camera. While you can use that, it just helps a lot more to diffuse sound. Think about that and that investment. I don't think I paid too much for this microphone. I know I got it from Amazon. It's worth the investment to me. It makes a difference. Again, to each their own, if you think it's worth the money. Okay, so I'm gonna move on, but it'll all connect. So the other accessory that I have for my camera is actually a cord, which I can show you guys now. I'm not gonna show you the whole thing because one end is plugged into my camera and the other is plugged into my laptop, and this is how I get that monitor set up. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pick up my laptop so that you guys can see. Hopefully you guys can, because I can't see anymore. This is what is propped up on my laptop, and I always pop it up somewhere. That's pretty much what I see every time I film, and it makes it a lot more convenient rather than using the tiny screen. The camera that I do have comes with a viewfinder, and it is 360 rotation, so I can flip it either way if need be. But it'll be kind of difficult, especially with having this bright ring light in front of my face, looking and being able to actually see it with my glasses, the glare, all of that. It'll be kind of difficult. You know, it's a little more convenient to have it on my laptop. All you need is a laptop, a cord, and your camera. The cord came with my camera. Only thing that you need to pay attention to is what type of laptop you own. So since I own a MacBook, I needed to have the adapter, since new MacBooks went to USB-C rather than just USB. I had to connect an adapter, this white part that you see here. So that's something that you'll have to invest in. And I think I had to pay $10 or $20 extra dollars to get the adapter. All you have to do is literally plug it in to your camera, plug it into your laptop, and it'll prompt up a screen, which I'll put in a clip of what it actually looks like when you first plug it in. Click on remote shoot, I think, and then it is live shoot, something like that, and then this screen will pop up. Okay, so now I'm about to get into a few of the settings that I have my camera on. I'm not gonna lie, when I pulled the camera out of the box, I pretty much went with that. So any of those settings are pretty much the same. The only thing that I do on the actual camera is change it to manual, but I usually just keep it on manual and go with that. The only other thing that I do on there is control the aperture. I don't really know too much specifically about aperture, but I do know that if I turn the knob one way, it'll let in more light, and if I turn in it the other way, it will block more light. That's something that I do, like if I'm going from inside to outside, there's more sunlight outside, so I may need to turn the aperture down so that it's not completely white on my camera versus when I'm inside, it's a little more dark and I want to kind of brighten up what you guys see. And letting in more light is basically what it says. It's letting in more light to the camera so that the picture is more illuminated. Two different things that I actually do on my actual camera, but I have a few things that I do on my laptop. So once I plug in my camera to my laptop, I see the live view, but you can also control a few things on here. So I will go ahead and I'm gonna screen record my laptop. Hopefully it doesn't overheat. So right now it's recording. So I'm going to, right now this is what you see when I'm recording. Here is the button where I can stop recording if I want to. That's where I can do that. It's convenient that I don't have to get up and turn the camera off. I can just click it from my laptop. These settings I don't usually mess with that much, and you can't really do it once the camera is already recording. But this one right here prompts a little circle and it'll basically just tell you if your camera is leveled and balanced. There is this, which I don't know too much about. I believe this rotates the picture. This is to control how much, why did my Siri go off? This is to control how much the image crops. And then you have the center detection, just like a box in the center of, there is the zoom, so I can magnify. Right now it's on 1x because it's basically just the normal display. And then you can go to 5, which will zoom in a little bit more, which for reference, it'll pretty much just get my eyes, like this much of my face. And then 10 will be literally just my eyes, or like right under my eyes. That's just for reference. But I don't really usually mess with any of that stuff because it's a little too much. I don't really need to touch that stuff. You know, it's convenient to have it there so I don't have to get up and do it on my camera. And it's a lot more difficult, I feel like, to do it on your camera, because right here on my laptop it's all right here and I can see everything. But on my camera you kind of have to go search for settings, and I don't do that. Also have my camera set on auto white priority. I just like to have a little more brightness, and that will make whites whiter and darks darker, which for me I like because it shows contrast, it gives a lot more color to the picture, and it adds brightness to the picture as well, which I personally like. So here are my settings on here. I don't usually mess with them, but I'm just going to show you so that you guys have them for reference. All of that pretty much stays the same. I just realized that a few of the things that I tweak on my laptop I can't control while I'm recording. So right now I'm going to go ahead and stop the camera so I can go ahead and do a screen recording of what I actually change on here. So I'll have to do a voiceover. Hopefully you guys don't mind that.
All right, so it is voiceover cure, ready to go. Sadly it's a little bit later, my voice is a little bit shot, so please bear with me, but try and follow my cursor and I'll kind of show you what I'm doing. But here's that circle that I was talking about. It helps you balance the camera. The color of the line will change if it's unbalanced, and it'll show you when it is leveled. Now we're moving on. I'm about to show you guys the zoom aspects of it, and I really love this zoom aspect with using this camera and the monitor setting, because not only can you zoom in through your laptop, but you can also control exactly where the camera is shooting. By clicking on the arrows, you can adjust exactly where the camera is focused at. So that's pretty cool. And I zoomed into 10 and showed you that you can move as well. But I like to use it on 1x. And if I zoom it in, I usually just manually do it myself so that I can control that. Now we're going to go ahead and move into the settings of the filters that go over the face. So I'm showing you guys each individual one. There's about 8 of them. And you guys can kind of go with what you like personally. And you can kind of tweak each one as well. But for the most part, I just keep mine on auto. It'll show you. You can also customize different ones and label them by using the dropper and clicking on certain things. It'll intensify certain tones and give you a certain look, so you can go through that and figure out what you like. But personally, I go to auto white priority, and that's what I usually stay on. So I'm just showing you guys a few features that you can just look at and see what they are automatically set on. I don't really usually mess with these things. I kind of showed you some differences within a few things, but for the most part, everything stays the same. This notch that I was showing you, I'm comparing it to exactly what we did before, and it's just the same thing in a different location. These are a few other things that I don't usually mess with. I just wanted to show you specific settings and all of that. My default settings is what I really wanted to show you guys, what strength I keep it sharp, the contrast, the saturation, and the color tone. I went ahead and zoomed in so that you guys can tell the sharpness and really look at the difference. Like if you look on my forehead or on the highlight on my nose, you can really see the strength of the sharpness, which I just help I feel like it helps you guys understand it better. And then there's the contrast, the saturation, and the color tone. And you can just mess with that. Some will make you look a little more green, some a little more purple or red. Now, here's where I think I messed up a little bit. I don't usually mess with this, and I kind of did it. And you'll see from the beginning of the video to the end, it'll look a little bit different. And I didn't recognize it. So I kind of screwed up and it kind of messed with a little bit of some stuff, but I don't think it's that noticeable.
All right, so that's pretty much it for all of that. I hope I was able to show it as good as possible, as well as possible. I hope it was as detailed enough. It's gonna be a little complicated, but just I hope I got information relayed across as best as possible. I use the camera battery that comes with it, and if that dies, then I will use a backup battery that I bought off of Amazon. They're just random batteries. I wouldn't really recommend them because it doesn't really tell you, but when those batteries die, the footage gets lost somehow, but they're a cheaper option. I would definitely suggest that you spend the extra money and get one that is made for the camera. The SD cards that I use, I'll put them on the screen. They're pretty standard. I haven't really tried any other ones. I have three SD cards. The 16 one I believe came with the camera, and then I bought the other two. They're pretty expensive, honestly. It'll get to be a lot once you have to constantly buy, but what I do is I film on it, get the content that I need. It'll hold a lot, to be honest. The 16 gigabyte will hold about one video. What I do is once I'm done, I will plug it into my laptop and export that off, delete it off of the SD card so I can reuse it rather than having to buy another one every time it's full. I just use them in rotation and it works perfectly fine. But that's pretty much it for what I can tell you now. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that this was very informative and that you guys can use this when developing your own tactics or trying to get your own setup. And yeah, so I love you guys so much, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys. Mwah.